gentlemen, you are now listening to the Moneyway Show.
Moneyway Show.
With your host, CJ Moneyway. Let's go.
I'ma stand on my position. I've always been a man and never ran from my position. I've always took a stand to expand on contradictions. How you cancel Kyrie but not your Amazon subscription? I'm from the Bay, so it's relevant. If we condemn him for the link, go after Bezos for selling it. I do not agree with his rhetoric, but we should scrutinize both sides, not just the guy with melanin. Now we about to take another elegant. It's costly when your gene pool is out of pocket, they relish in every misstep we take abrupt. So you can understand it takes less than four quarters to break a buck. LeVar Burton, we all searching for proof. Get caught with a black thought and they strangle you by your roots. They dangled us by a noose. If you do better than you'd measure misinformation from truth, not with the news fetters. They have to bait you in order to aggravate you. Continue to sell trauma and tell you they advocate you. There's only two ways we get to re-success. Either promote death or let them put you in a dress.
What's up, my good people? Welcome to the Moneyway Show. This is your host, CJ Moneyway. Thank you for tuning in with me today. Today is November 3rd, 2023. Today, like I said, I'm going to have a hot topic. Who determines what's disinformation? You know, almost about a year ago today is when Kyrie Irving got banged for talking about the Jews, as they say. But it was really because he posted a link on his social media account about a movie called Hebrews to Negroes. And so today is going to be a little topic of that, you know, a little conversation, a little dialogue, because in his way, this is his truth. Just like my man that wrote the movie and that wrote the books, this was their truth. And so everybody has entitlement to what they feel and what they want to talk about or what they want to do. And so if this man sat here and did all his research and did this movie, if you haven't seen it, you need to see it. My brothers who said that they didn't see it but still sitting here condemning Kyrie for putting it out there, but you didn't watch it. And so the disinformation came from when they told y'all that this was what was in the movie. That ain't what was in the movie. Wasn't none of that in the movie. Actually, what my man did was, it was really informative what he really did. A lot of research. He had to do a lot of research. I mean, man, this dude's talking about stuff I'd never heard before, and I've been going to church for a long time. He probably was talking about stuff in this movie that pastors don't even know about. That's how real it was. That's how much information that he had. Now, based on the fact that whether it's true or not in history, I don't know. I mean, that's not for me to judge. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, and this is just how I feel. This is how I feel. At the end of the day, none of us ever walked with Adam and Eve. None of us ever walked with Moses. None of us ever walked with Jesus. And so, therefore, anything that comes out in books, anything that anybody tells us is information that came from somewhere else. It's not firsthand information from none of us. And so to say that this man's information was disinformation because of how he felt and because of what he's trying to go with his life, because of what's been revealed to him, I don't think that that's disinformation. That's just his way of, that's just the way that he felt. And I don't think nothing was wrong with what Kyrie did because that's how he felt. That was his truth. You got to sit back and look at how they doing us right now. Just like, I guess it's disinformation about when our ancestors was in slavery. Because here it is, my man in Florida, he getting rid of the curriculums talking about that. That's about African-American history. Then you get the people in the House Republicans where they just sat there and dismantled the Civil Rights Department. So, come on, man. So what's disinformation? When they don't want you to know anything about yourself, they don't want you to do nothing about yourself, they don't want you to be able to defend yourself. Man, stick with me on this podcast, because we're going to get deeper in 2024, okay? We're going to talk about police brutality, Black Lives Matter, all that. Just stick with me on this. But right now, we're talking about what's real information. And what's disinformation, right? Because As I look at it, man, looking at this movie, going through it myself, I found out some stuff. It made me go back and look at some history and go back and read my Bible and look at some history. And one thing that stuck out to me was is that Moses, you know, he married a Ethiopian woman. So, Bathsheba, the one who Solomon had not Solomon, David had Solomon by, it was, you know, it's believed that her husband was black. The woman that Moses married, she was black. And here it is, David, and one of David's mighty warriors, Uriah, it said that he was possibly black. So, and this was Bathsheba's husband, the one who David slept with and had Solomon by. So, come on, man. Moses, he was a Jew, but he apparently married a black African woman. And it was approved by God. And we can find that in scripture. It say, because in response to Marion's criticism, God does not get angry at Moses. He gets angry at Marion. The criticism had to do with Moses' marriage and Moses' authority. The most explicit statement relates to the marriage. Marion and Aaron, his brother, spoke against Moses because of the Cushite woman whom he had married. For he had married a Cushite woman whom they had determined was Ethiopian, black. Then God strikes Marion with leprosy. The question is, why? Why? Why did they hate on Moses because he married a black woman? Why didn't God get mad at Moses for marrying a black woman? God approved it. Because God approved Moses. Moses was God's man. He was the one who he sent to the Pharaoh to bring his people out of captivity. And so my thing is with this disinformation is, see, sometimes people just want to act like we just came from nowhere. You know, they reference us saying that we came from monkeys. Remember when they did that thing about Michelle Obama and they did the comic books and everything in the comic pages and they had her looking like a monkey? That ain't funny, bruh, because this is how they try to label us. We ain't come from no monkeys. We came from the true and living God. We was created by the true and living God just like everybody else. But they want to treat us as something different, but we not. We had a history somewhere. We just didn't come out of nowhere. So no, they don't want to believe that we came from the loins of Noah's son Ham, and that they got in scripture where, you know, they was cursed. But don't nobody want you to believe and see that part of history, whether they was cursed or whether they was blessed or whatever. We came from somewhere. We just didn't fall out of a tree. We don't have the same. We don't walk and talk the same just like everybody else for no reason. So to say that somebody that's following their truths, somebody that's going by what they believe in, to say what they putting out is disinformation is wrong on your part. Because this is how they feel. Have you dug into the scriptures? Have you dug and went to where this man have went and did the research that this man have researched? He didn't talk about no Hitler. He didn't talk about the Holocaust. It was nothing in this movie that I saw. Maybe it was part two. Maybe it was part one, whichever one I saw. It didn't talk about nothing like that. He was talking about how we was God's chosen people. Now, whether that's the right thing or the wrong thing, that's still his information that he wanted to put out there that he did. Now, can anybody else tell me what he said was wrong? Can anybody tell me why is it disinformation what he put out there? Who walked in the times of Moses? Who walked in the times of David? Who walked in the times of Jeremiah? Who walked in the times of Isaiah? Who walked in the times of Malachi? Who walked in the times of Jesus? Tell me one person that's living right now that walked in those times. None of us. None of us walked in those times. So everything that we hear, everything that we see, It comes from somebody that's showing us this. And so then you determine what's the real information and what's disinformation. I don't agree with that. I don't agree with that. Now, I'm not saying that it's right, but I'm not saying that it's wrong. Do I think that certain parts of it is true? Yeah, I do believe certain parts of it true. Like I said, we didn't come from no monkeys. We didn't come from no apes. We are loved and chosen. God has given us mercy and grace just like he's given everybody else. Have people gone through hard times? Who haven't? We're not the only race that has gone through hard times. We're not the only race that have poor people in it. We're not the only race that got people in jail.
I was only married for 30 days at that moment. And I didn't know 11 days later I would lose my wife. So my job, we won't all, because I realize that death is a thing that happens in life. It's not a thing that happens to life. So my job is to go and tell everyone that is living to make life count. Make it count. I don't care what it is. I don't care what it is. And as you breathe today, when was the last time you took a big, deep breath? As I pulled my wife's monitor off and she took her last one. Right now, take a deep one. Let it out. As long as you have that in your body, you got the Brady effect. That at any moment, I got time on the clock. I can come back at any moment. I know things happen in my life, but I can make a change at any moment. Well, I came here today to tell you, to encourage all of you that's going through a difficult time, that trouble don't last always. That I've never seen a cloud sit over one person's house for a long time. This too shall pass. It has to. Today to tell you all why you're here, to endure this thing. We've been made to endure the night, for our joy will come in the morning.
Everybody goes, every race in this country goes through something, but we get treated the worst. We get treated the worst. And so, therefore, this information that's coming out, it just makes me wonder. It makes me think. Why don't y'all want us to know certain things? Because y'all want to put us in a box. Y'all want to trap us and just make us think and believe what you want us to make us believe. Like how y'all told us about Christopher Columbus. We ain't going to even get into that. We ain't going to even get into that. Now, that was disinformation. But that was information that y'all put in history books for us to look at. History books for us to ingrain in our minds that Christopher Columbus discovered America. And now that I'm older, we know that was disinformation, but y'all still pass that on as if it's real information. But when a black man says something, when a black man stands up for something that he believes in, when a black man want to tell his side of the story and what he feel, you can't do that. You can't do that. And then to have other black men, other black women to come out against somebody that's trying to stick up and trying to learn something for his own people, whether it's for him, the people that's following him, that believe in the same things that they believe in, however the case may be, y'all want to knock him and take everything away from him. Why is that? That don't make you say, You know, in life, there's some things that make you say, And so you got to start going back and researching things for yourself. I mean, you really do, man. I mean, because this thing is crazy, man. And then I found something else out. They talked about, he's talking about the Jews and this. But it's different sets of Jews, right? I mean, as far as I know. I'm not getting into the Jewish thing and this and that or whatever. But it's different types, because I found something out. It say that he had James, the brother of John, put to death with the sword. When he saw that this met with approval among the Jews, he proceeded to seize Peter. So the Jews killed John, one of Jesus' disciples. And so that he saw that, so the king saw that this was a pleasing to the Jews. So he went to go get Peter, the rock, also. Then it say that, then Peter came to himself and said, now I know without a doubt that the Lord has sent his angel and rescued me from Haran's clutches and from everything the Jewish people were hoping would happen. Is that disinformation? Is that disinformation? Somebody tell me, please. Because right here it's saying that the Jews wanted to kill the disciple. Same Jews that killed Jesus. But yet and still, when the black man say that the black people was God's chosen people, he wrong for even thinking it. It's not necessarily that it was true. He was wrong for even thinking it. They don't even want you to think on your own. Oh, I know this gonna step on some toes. I know everybody ain't gonna agree with what I'm saying. Hey, this the Moneyway Show. I ain't here to please everybody. See, because I ain't got the bag. I ain't got no bag. That's just be straight up honest with this. I ain't got no bag. I ain't got $1 million. I ain't got $1,000 for that matter. So if I say something, I'm going to say it, but you can't make me go back and retract what I said, because that's how I feel. So cause you can't sway the bag over me. You can't say, well, if you say that and don't take it back, take back what you said, then I'm going to take your bag. I ain't got no bag to begin with. So you ain't got nothing to take from me. So therefore, here on the CJ Moneyway Show.
That's offensive. What? This is how I feel inside.
I'm going to tell it how it is, because this is how I feel. I'm not speaking for nobody else. I want you to hear it and have your own thought process, process it yourself, and tell me what you get from it, and then we can talk about it. And we can agree to disagree. It ain't no arguments. This is just how I feel. This is how I saw the situation. And I'm pretty sure that it was a whole bunch of barbershops and beauty shops and cooler talk at work about this. And everybody had their own opinion. Everybody felt the way that they felt about it. So I'm not saying nothing no different than what everybody else was talking about around the water fountain. So I'm talking about how I felt about the situation. I'm talking about how I view it, how I saw it, how I see it, what it made me go back and do. So again, somebody tell me who determines what's real information and what's disinformation? Because I'm reading the Bible and I'm seeing things that's not lining up with your disinformation. So again, somebody come tell CJ Moneyway on the Moneyway Show and help me understand what was wrong with another man's view. Tell me what's wrong with another man's researches that he did to the ends of the earth to try and find his true identity and the identity of his people. That's his truth. That's what he believed. Just like anybody, like I said, just like anybody, you believe what you want to believe. And so what was wrong with this man believing what he wanted to believe? We all have a freedom of thinking and feeling how we feel. But when it comes to blacks having a thought and put their thoughts in motion and ruffle some feathers along the way, they wrong for even having a thought about who God is to them, who Christ is to them, who the Hebrews are to them. There's been times people tell us to go back to where we came from. They tell us go back to Africa. We know Canaan was cursed. We know the land of Canaan was the land that God had promised the Israelites. But you all try to make it seem like blacks never existed in those times and like it's a sin for these brothers to feel the way that they feel. That's how they feel. That's what they believe. No different than these people getting on these new channels and every day had a leader of the free world lying to the people every day. And now more than ever before in my lifetime, the lie is the truth. And the truth is a lie. And depending on what side of the fence you are on that day, what truth you said yesterday might be a lie tomorrow. Because that's how they spin it. That's how they spinning it. I could tell you a lie on this side and The truth is on the other side. But then when I get put in that situation, now I can sit over here and tell you another lie that was the truth over there, but it's the truth now because I said that it's the truth. They doing it every day. They spinning these type of things on us daily. But ain't nobody calling that disinformation. Ain't nobody saying what they saying is wrong when we know for a fact that is wrong. We know for a fact that you sitting up here lying to our face. You can't sit here and tell me that you ain't lying. Come on now. A lot of us parents, we know when our kids lying. I'm grown. I am real grown. So I know for a fact when somebody lying to me. You just can't lie to me and just tell me anything, man. And that's what they doing in society right now. They lie to us, tell us anything, and just want you to believe it. And if you don't believe it, so what? So what? Don't nobody care about what you think. Nobody care about how you feel. But when a black man get out there and say something about scripture, when he say something about God, when he say something about the Holy One, when he say something about the Alpha and Omega, when he say something about black people are not the people whom y'all make us out to be, it's a problem with that. And I got a problem with that. I got a problem with that because I am black. I am black. And I am somebody. And I know God created me from the dust just like he created all of y'all from the dust. He created me from the dust just like he created you from the dust. He gave me a living soul just like he gave you a living soul. He gave me a thought process just like he gave you a thought process. So don't sit here and act like God don't love me just as much as he loved you. God said that he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He didn't say that he just loved you. He didn't say that he just loved you or just loved you or just loved you. He said that he so loved the world. And I'm part of the world. So he loved me just as much as he loved anybody else. He loved Kyrie just as much as he loved anybody else. He loved a brother who wrote the movie and the book just as much as he loved anybody else. So to say that whatever they did was disinformation, no, I'm saying what you saying is disinformation because you put stuff out there that wasn't true. And then we got people who don't have we got rich, smart, intelligent people, man, who did not go out there and see it for themselves, just took the bag's word. Because it wasn't about the truth, it was about the bag. It was about the bag. I didn't care less about the truth. You get out there and say that he did wrong. Yeah, he shouldn't have never did that. He did wrong. He shouldn't have said that. He shouldn't have never said that black people, was the chosen people. There's no way that we are the chosen people. There's no way that we could ever be the chosen people. We the white man, we the flunkies. You know, they give us the money, they tell us what to do, and we just go out there and do it. And nigga, that's how we live.
Mess with me, God pick me. I don't care what you think about me. God still got his hand on me. You might not have liked my decision, but God still loves me. And let me tell you something. Don't mess up your future trying to judge my past. You better hear what I said. Don't mess up your tomorrow trying to look at my yesterday. Your business is your business. My business is my business.
Exactly. 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 Let me say that again. Apparently because the wokies are trying to destroy America by engaging in radical behavior like promoting understanding, thinking about others, and making the world a slightly less awful place for people who have historically haven't had much say in how things work. Again, who determines what's real information and what's disinformation? Because evidently, we don't got no say in what goes on in history. We ain't got no say in what's going on in the world. We ain't got no say. We never had any type of say. Even with the Black Lives Matter thing, like I said, I don't want to get too ahead of myself right now because I got a two-part series of that coming later on down the line. But even with all the things that's going on now, even with that, Is it really making a, is it really putting a dent in anything? Yeah, we talking. People going out there protesting. People it's doing a whole lot of things, but is it really making a difference? Do they really care? Do they really care? I mean, you just got to think about that. Do they really care about how you feel? As long as they can keep you under their thumb, as long as they can keep you asleep or whatever, what they call is woke now, well, you know, and they don't even understand what that word means. It's just something that came out there in the atmosphere and they just went with it. Anybody that tries to have an understanding about anything in the world, any type of understanding about how things is going on, they want to keep you asleep. So they use the opposite. So they say that you woke. Oh, y'all think y'all woke now. So basically they saying that, you know, you think you woke. Y'all think y'all woke and y'all think y'all know everything. Y'all don't know nothing because we running everything. And we are the ones who determine what's disinformation. And so when my man them came out with this movie and Kyrie posted it on his social media page, immediately drew backlash because that is something they do not want you to know. Anytime in our American history, if something has happened that they didn't want to happen, people get into an uproar. They get into an uproar. They made it a big, man, they took his gym shoe deal, kicked him off the team, wanted him to apologize. They wanted him to kiss the ring. Kiss the ring. Kicked him off the team, all that, man. So anytime you get to that type of level of whatever, you know what I'm saying? It's because it was something that they didn't want you to ever even think about. Not saying that it's real. I keep saying it. Not saying that it's true. Not saying that it's that it's facts. But they don't even want you to think about it. Think about what I said, man. This dude over here in Florida just sat there and got the African American studies taken off the book, said, no, that's disinformation. We don't want that. They just sat here. They just got the house not too long ago. And already has dismantled the civil rights division. Come on, man. What y'all not seeing? What y'all not seeing? And I ain't gonna even talk about you brothers and sisters that's on the other side talking about these policies was the best. We ain't gonna even get into that. But anyway, you know, it's amazing how we as people don't see what's going on right in front of our very own eyes. We act like it's going on right in front of us. And we act like we don't see it. LeBron, he a millionaire. And they told LeBron to just shut up and dribble the ball. We talking about a millionaire now. A billionaire. A billionaire. They told him to shut up and dribble the ball. This man can buy you. But yet and still, no respect for a black man with money. Because they don't have respect like that for the black man. We want them to. We rub elbow because they got the money. We want them to like it because we want to do business. You know, we want to prosper. We want to be multi-billionaires. It's only a few of us out there like that. But, you know, there's brothers and sisters with a lot of money and this and that. That's what we want. That's the status. That's what you try to get to. So we want that. But yet and still, do they respect you? Do they respect you? Not what you do. Do they respect you? This lady told LeBron to shut up and dribble with basketball. Now, I can just imagine if they ever heard my podcast, what they'd tell me with my broke self. I can go jump in the lake somewhere. Kill yourself. You know what I'm saying? Kill yourself. That's what they'd tell me. But hey, that's why I'm here on the Moneyway Show. Sitting here in my garage doing my show in the garage, man. Ain't got no shame to it. All big things start small. And this is my starting point. This is my starting point. And this is why I'm trying to figure out and trying to get some information about who determines what's real information and what's disinformation. You feel me? I mean, I just look at how they did, how they done some of our black people over time. Like I said, I'm a big Tupac fan. Talking, what, Tupac almost been gone, what, 30 years almost? And that, when he went to jail, Pac was one of the most recognizable people in the world. But they still put him in jail. It was his word against her word. There was no real evidence, but he had a voice. And not just a voice, but a voice that was talking about something. A voice that was talking about things that had substance. You see what I'm saying? See, it's a difference when you're talking about something and ain't talking about nothing. It's a difference. So he had to sit down. And so when that didn't work, he had to go. Because we may not knew it, but he was a threat to them because he was spitting knowledge and he was talking about things that they felt shouldn't have been talked about. See, they want to keep us with blinders on, man. And it's our fault that we continue to wear the blinders when we don't have to. We don't have to see things the way that they make us see it, man. God has opened up your eyes to see things the way that you need to see it. So we choose to walk around blindly. We choose to be held by the hand and having somebody to take us to and fro of where we need to go or where they want us to go. That's our choice. That's our choice. So my man was taking blinders off of cats, having you seeing the real. When my man say they don't really about us. Man, you better go get them better days. I'm talk about that in another episode too. But anyway, but yeah, man, you know that's how they do us, man. Look how they did Ali. Look how they did Ali. In the prime of his career, man. Stripped him of his belt. They tried to take his morale, man. They tried to break him down to the very last pieces, man. But the dude was too strong, man. He was too his ego, his inner being was just too well put together. They couldn't just put him down like that, but they wanted to. They took everything from him, man. Took his belt, took his money, everything, bro. But he came back. Because he fought through it. He's you know, saying he withstood what they was trying to do to him. But they did it. We talking about Muhammad Ali, man. They did Muhammad Ali like that, bro. I mean, look what they did to Tyson. They put Tyson away. One of the greatest heavyweight fighters of all times, bro. Now, I'm not saying that he didn't do what they said that he did. You know, everybody know Mike was Mike. So I'm not saying that he didn't. All I'm saying is, man, look how they do us, man. Look how they do us. Now, I'm not talking about the brothers that's running criminal empires and got millions from making movies that they put themselves in that situation. A totally different situation. Some of us put ourselves in situations and some of us get thrown into situations. Depending on who you are, depending on what type of influence you got. Now I take that back. I will go back and say my man that was running the criminal empire, everybody say that he did good in the community. You know what I'm saying? Although it wasn't on the up and up. His music was on the up and up, but his sad stuff wasn't on the up and up. So he was giving away turkeys and doing stuff for the community and all that. You know what I'm saying? Man, come on, man. Come on, man. They probably would have just let him go if he would. They would have let him go if he was just doing what he's doing. But when you talking about helping your own people, when you talking about helping your own kind, nah, you can't do that. Can't do that. Can't do that. Got to go. So then again, Bible say, what profits a man to gain the whole world and then loses his soul? So what profits you to sit there and knock my man Kyrie for what he believed in because you trying to gain the whole world. But then you lose your soul. So what profit did you really get? Yeah, you got generational wealth for your family to come down the line and this and that, whatever. But how big of a man do you really feel, man, knocking your other brother that's sitting up there trying to give some insight, and not necessarily to you, but to people who want to hear what they talking about. So who are you to sit there and knock him for trying to reach back and say, hey, black people, y'all need to check this out. It may not be all the way real, but there's some substance in here that we can pick from. Y'all knocked him on that, man. Y'all didn't even give him a chance on that because y'all trying to gain the whole world. It is what it is, man. To this dude, man, he running for president. They talking about him running for president. And a lot of y'all cats going to go out here and vote for him because y'all don't know no better. If this dude sat here and got rid of African-American history in his state, if he became president of the United States, what you think he going to do then? What you think their agenda going to be then? Especially if they had a House, if they had a Senate, and the presidency, and the White House. What you think they're going to do, man? You think they're going to sit there, they're going to give us everything that we want? You think they just going to love us? Like, huh, here y'all go, ooh, we just love y'all black people so much. We just love y'all. We going to make sure we do everything for you and give you all your demand. We going to defund the police. We going to defund the police. And you know what I'm saying? Because we understand where you coming from. Not. And I don't even know what makes y'all believe that. At all. Period. That's just the stupidest thing ever. Because y'all walking around with blinders on. Huh? Leave me to what you want me to know. Tell me what you want me to say. Tell me what you want me to think. Come on, man. If he banned them courses, he said that we must ban this course because it might. This is what he said. We must ban this course because it might make my white child feel bad that slavery happened. And worse yet, that racism still exists in America. They not satisfied that our people were in slavery for 400 years and beyond, because even out of slavery, they still enslaved us. Even out of slavery, they still enslaved us. Look what they did to my man Emmett Till, man. Check me out, August 2024. I got a special on Emmett Till, a show just dedicated to Emmett Till, because I just watched the Till movie not too long ago, and it was amazing, man. I was baffled, because there was a lot of things that I didn't know. That was way before my time, but we talking about 1955. So slavery had been over with a long time ago. Now we talking about people in, you know, they in the South and all over, this and that, whatever, but it was still things that black people couldn't do because they still had us enslaved. Look what they did to King now. When they was marching for civil rights, bruh. When they was just marching just to vote, man. To vote. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself either, because I got a special on Dr. King in January. But come on, man. Just to vote. And here it is now in 2023, and we thinking that voting, we don't want to vote. We see how they doing in Georgia. Now they sitting around, man, half of y'all probably don't even know this stuff, man, because y'all walking around with blinders on. Man, you better open up your eyes and see what's going on, man. This just ain't for us. Some of this thing probably won't even happen in our time. I don't care how, you can be 20 years old right now. It may not happen in your time. So it's not for us. This is for our seeds, man. We got seeds coming behind us. We got seeds coming behind us. Seeds. They was enslaved for 400 years, bro. So do you think that all that granddaddy, whoever started the tribe or whatever, that they saw all them in 400 years? No. Just like we not gonna see all our family, all our seeds over time. But over time, these things that they trying to put in force right now, it's going to affect them. But right now, we don't care, because it's not helping me. So you're not going to do nothing to try to improve and help your seeds. We ain't going to get on that either. Got a whole thing on that one too. Father's Day. Come on, man. Get at your boy, CJ Moneyway, man. But anyway, we're not paying attention to the things going on around us, you know. They act, and actually, man, they slowly but surely taking us back to those times. Y'all say, give me a $1,500 check. He was the best. He gave us some money. Yeah, they give you $1,500. But they taking $15 billion off the top. And then they take that $1,500 that they gave you, then they taxing that. Come on, man. Money ain't everything, bro. And you talking about that's broke. Money ain't everything. And I love money just as much as anybody else. I like taking my wife out to dinner. I like going buying my son gym shoes. I like going out just doing little stuff. Everybody need money. We talked about that already. Oh, saying that, yeah, everybody that didn't get money, you know, they always talking about money. Nah, it ain't everything. It ain't everything. Money is not going to make me sell my soul. Money, because you give me $1,500, not going to say, oh, yeah, you just the greatest ever. That's a lie. I'm not finna sit here and lie. That's a lie. And he lied to you, lied to me, lied to everybody. He lied to himself. So if somebody lied to yourself, if you lied to yourself, who you going to tell the truth to? He lied to himself daily. Daily. Lied to himself daily. But yet and still, he telling you the truth. Okay. We ain't going to even get on that. I don't want nobody coming to my house. But yeah, man, you know, we just got to do better, man. I really enjoyed this conversation here. I know I probably got a little hyper, this and that. But hey, man, again, when somebody find out who determines what's disinformation or what's real information, get at your boy, man. Get at your boy. Holla at me. Holla at me. You know what I'm saying? Because, and I got some series on this too, man, because the enemy don't do nothing, man, but come to steal, kill, and destroy, man. And in a lot of facets of our life, man, that's exactly what he doing. Killing our joy. They killing our freedom, bruh. They killing our kids in the streets. Our kids killing our kids in the streets. They're killing us in the school system. So if they're killing us everywhere, man, then where we going to win at? Where we going to live at? If they're killing us everywhere else, where we going to live? But somebody say that they'd rather die on their feet than they'd rather live like a man on their feet than die on their knees. Man, you better start getting on your knees, man. And I ain't talking about no punk stuff either. I'm talking about the real, real. Better start getting on your knees and start praying. Start saying thank you, man. Start being grateful for some things in your life. That's the problem with most of us. We're not grateful. We're not thankful. We want the mercy. We want the grace, but we don't want to give the thanks. Where the thanks at? Where the amen at? Huh? Where the worship at? We want everything else, but we don't want to give him what he deserves. So we don't want to get on our knees and pray. Because we don't feel no need for it. But, oh, I'm here to tell you, it's a need. It's definitely a need. This your boy, CJ Moneyway. Hope you enjoyed the show. Get at me next time.